give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord of Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant you, great Almighty God, that by St. Joseph's intercession, your Church may constantly watch over the unfolding of the mysteries of human salvation, whose beginnings were entrusted to his faithful care. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading in the second book of Samuel. The Lord spoke to Nathan and said, "Go, tell my servant David, when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will rise up your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. It is he who shall build a house for my name, and I will make his royal throne firm forever. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever." The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home, for it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. Then Joseph awoke. He did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him, and took his wife into his home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So I was thinking of the Feast of St. Joseph today, and thinking of all that is happening to our church and to our society, our nation, how we have gone from just washing our hands really, really good, to social distancing, keeping our distance from people, to limiting the number of people that we are around, to now the new term is sheltering in place, really kind of isolating ourselves. And I'm thinking, what would St. Joseph have to say about this? St. Joseph, the one who guided Jesus and Mary in their early family life, and protected them, and kept them from harm, fled to Egypt to escape the terror of Herod, and all the amazing things that Joseph did. What would he have to say to us today? What would be his words of wisdom to us today? Well, I think Joseph would be, like Joseph always is, silent. He would not say one word to us. Not because he didn't want to, but because he doesn't have to. Because what Joseph is, who he is, and what he did speaks volumes to us today, I think, on this particular day of all days. There's two things about St. Joseph that are sometimes overlooked, and that is how God called him in his life and his response to that call. And that's something I think that we need to pay attention to. A couple of days ago, I saw a little cartoon that kind of fascinated me. It was a cartoon of a little batty duck. And the daddy duck says, is holding his little child, his little duckling in his arms, or his feathers, I guess is what he's doing. He says, as your father, I promise to do everything to keep you safe from harm. And then the little thought balloon of the little duckling, as your kid, I promise to fight you on that every step of the way. That is what we do. We fight and we resist every step of the way. And in the last couple of weeks, we've kind of been shutting ourselves down. We've gone from these big celebrations in our church down to no celebrations in our church and really kind of isolating ourselves. We have oftentimes resisted that every step of the way, even though it is for our own good. That we not just wash our hands and keep ourselves clean and pure, but also that if we happen to have the virus, that we don't engage in other people who would give that advice. So it's not just about isolating ourselves and taking care of ourselves. It's about protecting the ones around us, the ones we love the most, our friends, our family, and our fellow parishioners. So we need to kind of go for a time just in this new way and not resist it. You know, Joseph didn't resist. He had this call that his wife was found without child, with child in this unimaginable way. He didn't know what to do. He was confused. He was going to do the righteous thing, the right thing, to force her quietly, not to cause attention, not to draw attention to her, not to scandalize her or to mock her in any way, but just deal with it quietly until the angel appeared to him and said, Joseph, this is what you need to do. This is who you are. This is what you are called to do. And Joseph, in pure docility and pure openness to the call of God to the angel, was able to say yes in his way. And he was able to act on it. See, the thing is that oftentimes we don't open our hearts enough to receive the call, to receive the plan of God in our life. We fight and resist. We put up barriers and blocks to it. Through Joseph's intercession today, we need to pray that we might have open hearts to how God is calling us to be right now for ourselves and for those around us and for our wider community, to discern that call for each and every one of us. And Joseph, St. Joseph's intercession can help us in that. And then second, what is our response to that call going to be? says nothing. He just does. He just acts. Because he is a good and righteous man. And as a result, he protected Jesus and Mary at the time that they needed protection. Therefore, he is an amazing model for all fathers and for all families to take care not only of our home, but those around us as well. The thing, the word that came to me this morning as I was praying the liturgy of the hours is that this is kind of a great reboot for us. It's like God is pulling the plug out of the computer and we're going to plug it back in so that we can maybe be and act and think and pray a little differently on the other side of this entire crisis. But he never leaves us alone. We are not by ourselves. The Lord Jesus is always at our side. And he's given us the great and amazing saints of our church, St. Joseph, our Blessed Mother Mary, and all of our patron saints, and our guardian angels, and the whole heavenly host. They are there, waiting for us to invite them into this time. Invite them into our lives. So St. Joseph, husband of the Blessed Virgin Mary, pray for us during this time. Pray for us that we might be able to hear the call of God in our lives and respond to the call of God in our lives, just as you did. Praise be Jesus Christ now and forever.
Amen.
Let us profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We now offer up all of our prayers and petitions and place them before our Heavenly Father. We pray for our church throughout the world, for Pope Francis and for all of our bishops, that they may lead and guide and shepherd their flock with a father's heart. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For an end to the scourge of the coronavirus across the world, that through the intercession of St. Joseph and our Mother Mary, God's grace may flow to bring healing and hope to all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church in Western Washington and our local parish communities may respond generously to the most vulnerable and to those in need of food, shelter, and care. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our sick, that they be healed and be given hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dying may be aided by St. Joseph's intercession and our beloved dead may experience the joy of eternal communion with God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the prayers that we each bring to this Mass, which we hold within our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God and Father, with confidence and trust, we offer you these prayers this day, and we ask that you please hear and answer them through Christ our Lord. was conceived by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service that our whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." Lord be with you.